when you DJ and you get it right, you play the right thing at the right time. I've had spiritual moments with crowds DJing. Every time I've made a beat, I've wanted it to feel like it's a hit. Electronic music and dance music now is the ability to do anything I want. And that's cool. When I was a kid, I was really angry. I was just constantly looking for like father figures and support. It was just me and my mum, that classic story. So we was on our own doing our thing.
His mother remarried his stepfather, but they never really clicked.
She kind of forced a relationship between me and my stepdad. Her way of getting that across was being very strict.
I mean, we look so relaxed, but I am a very hard one to deal with.
I used to basically steal CDs from my dad. He had like this epic CD collection and I'd just low-key nick it, make a copy and put it back.
Yeah, it was hard.
He brought a lot of musical influence, but it was a really turbulent relationship between everyone. I remember a pivotal point for me for music was my guitar teacher, Tim Pels, just gave me the littest guitar like he had. It was like super expensive.
I sat him down one time and I just thought that the instrument that he was playing was inadequate. And so I thought, well, we've got a great guitar. It's not being used. Give it to him.
This is where I used to make beats here. I used to have that my little four track of my keyboard, my guitar. I'd play my beats for 3 minutes.
I showed him a little multi-track recorder. He immediately started doing loops. I think he composed his first pieces on that.
When he was at Center of Young Musician, he saw a lot of his friends were going to the Pentecostal church. So he started joining them and started playing there on Saturday.
It's like, hark the angels, you know, it's hymns, yo. It's not like, hey, praise you in the morning, praise, you know. So a strange interbalanced relationship. Being very Roman Catholic became like a heavy, guilty relationship where I felt like I wanted to conform, but then at the same time became a place where, yeah, I could use my musical gifts to kind of communicate with people, bring people together and learn more about music outside of like a formal training, you know? Praise and worship is powerful. My parents, they're both teachers, so that says it all. They wanted me to become a doctor or an accountant, something safe. I accepted to do a degree, so I did a degree in financial accounting. But I was just chasing music, going to the studio, making beats every day. I wanted to like pursue it as part of a career, which, yeah, caused problems in my house, to be fair.
I have never in the world would ever think that one day our son would become an artist. Never.
Once university finished, friend and family had a garage that he put a cooker in, and all I wanted to do was prove them wrong. After a few years of doing like session guitaring, making it work, I joined the band. We signed the record deal and a whole heap of money dropped in my account. Boom.
When the early days when we first started seeing each other, he was trying to portray successful musician.
I used to carry like these £50 notes and just drop them on the table, trying to be the big man in the room.
Me and Jax met, he was part of a band. His label had asked me to produce. Got in the studio and I immediately realised that the project was going absolutely nowhere.
That band wasn't me. Like, I saw everything as an opportunity, but resultantly, I had like a nose piercing, started to get these weird rubbish tattoos. Ultimately, it wasn't really true to like who I was.
at the time where the band was kind of crumbling, he was struggling with a bit of depression. Jax had always been in search of a father figure in the music industry, and then he met Duke Dumont and looked up to him massively.
The first song I heard that I knew was a hit was the track that became I Got You for Duke Dumont.
It was a very confusing time. People would not pay me, they would cheat me, cut me off on credits.
Jax was the guy who was doing all music but getting absolutely no credit for what he was doing.
Anything that I thought I was fighting for kind of meant nothing. Was meant to be the beginning of Jax Jones, the beginning of me, but my little light that was kind of trying to grow bigger was just getting smaller and smaller because I was just a side man.
I had quite an honest conversation with him. I think I gave him a lot of reassurance.
I think that was where it was so lucky that I met Deandra. We joked that maybe she was the final father figure.
I don't think I'm his father figure, but I think after the final blow, the true Jax Jones was born.
Jax Jones is a mission statement. It means to do something on your own. When I finally got rid of all that luggage that I was carrying, Housework happened. You Don't Know Me happened. Instruction, Breathe, Now It's My Ring Ring. It must be everything I've ever gone through just comes out in that day that I spend writing a song. Nothing beats the first 10% of making a song when you realize you have something really good. I'm then imagining all the people that are gonna fall in love with this record, all the kids that will annoy their parents dancing to it, all the old school ravers that tell me it reminds me of my youth. And my mum will say, yeah, I like that one, son, that was cool. That's my favorite point. When I first broached the idea of doing dance music, it was like, okay, what is this? But reality is, it just anything goes. To me, it's like a puzzle that appears simple, but I find it very complex at the same time. Ding, ding. Everyone that didn't believe in me up to this point, I can't say nothing. You know, the guy that said that I can't produce, well, that's chill. Someone told me I'd never be able to finish a record on my own. That's not true.
From that first A&R who told me he is not a producer, don't let him near the computer. How wrong could that have been?
I can't discredit all those guys that let me down over the years, because I did learn a hell of a lot. I took a piece. Kind of know more.
Hey, bruv, I brought a friend with me today to let people know what time it is when they come to Big Man Club Rouse.
Having seen him from the start when we had three people in the club and seeing him now, I mean, it's emotional, it's incredible. It's an amazing experience.
Hello, you there? Real tech, you got me going crazy. Hello.
I've become that person that I was hoping to be when I looked in the mirror. So if it has to be via this film that I see, that my parents are cool with it now, big up.